Hi, I'm Paige, and in this video, I'm going to show you how I made this sewing machine cover. It's made up of almost entirely scraps, and it's a good way to use all the pieces of fabric that you've collected, or you can design a custom color scheme. It's really up to you. I'm going to walk you through the process of how to put it together, and it should fit a wide variety of sewing machines. This is just a standard sewing machine, and if you want to see any of the details written out or the finished measurements, I have a link to my blog in the description box below where you can check out all the information that's in the video written out, as well as a full supply list and just everything kind of put into one space that's written for you. Let's jump right into the tutorial now. To begin, you're going to cut out 84 squares that are 3 by 3 inches. And then with your background fabric, you're going to cut 102 of these 3 by 1 inch rectangles. Then you're gonna sew those two places together, and you're going to be sewing the white rectangle on either the left or the right side, but just make sure that with the orientation of the fabric, it's always on the same side. So in this case, it's on the right side. Then you're gonna press your seams open once you've connected all of your pieces. Now you can begin arranging all of your squares. When I do this, I just make sure that two colors that are similar aren't next to each other, or depending on whatever your design is, this is when you lay out your plan. Once you've finalized everything, you can then combine your pieces. So the way that I do this is I begin with making a pair, and I get all my pairs together and press them. All the seams are pressed open. And then I'll begin by attaching all the rows and adding a white rectangle on the end of the rows. Once your rows are done, then you can add your white long rectangles that go between the rows. So these are just 1 inch wide strips. You're gonna sew them and press that seam open. And then you'll attach the rows together. When I match the seams, I'm looking to make sure that this intersection matches up perfectly, and then I'll place a pin. And I do that on each white section throughout, just making sure it's matched up and pinned all the way across, and then I will stitch. And here is what the finished panel looks like. It's 6 squares wide and 10 rows long, and you can see everything is pressed and ready. So we're gonna set that aside, and I'm gonna demonstrate the quilting process on the side panels. So you'll have your backing fabric with the right side facing down. You'll lay your batting onto it. And then you'll put the side panel, which is 3 squares wide by 4 squares tall. And here I'm just using curved pins and securing all three of these layers together to prepare for quilting. And here you can see that I have done straight line quilting throughout the whole thing, and I'll link to a quilting video down below if you need any help in the process of actually doing the quilting. Now I'm going to trim all of that excess backing and batting off, and this is my side panel. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to shape the top of it. So I'm taking my ruler and drawing in a curved line, and I'm going to do this on both of the corners on the top and stitch along that line. Then you can simply cut away this excess that you don't need. And here you have your finished side panel. With both of the side panels, you're going to baste on your piping, just that top edge, but not on the bottom. And then you'll match the rows with the right sides together and pin that in place. And then take the other side of the main panel and match along there. So you can see the main panel's, you know, folded along this, and we'll just pin it to the top and around the curve. So you'll stitch that, and then you can bind the raw edges with double fold bias tape. And to do this, you stitch it on and then hand sew the other side down so you don't have any visible stitches. And this is what it looks like when you turn it to the outside. A nice clean finish. Once you've done that, you can then open this up and look at it from the inside and press the seams toward the main panel, the light pink right here. And do the same thing to the other side, just like this. So now that both sides are finished, we can then bind the bottom. So now I'm gonna take this double fold bias tape and just bind along the bottom. So I'll treat this the same way as the inside. I'll stitch it on and then fold it over and hand sew it. So once you have sewn this binding on, it is finished and ready to be used. So you can put it on your sewing machine just like that. And my favorite thing about quilting is putting it in the wash and the dryer, and it kind of crinkles up. I haven't done that yet, and I'm about to do it because I just love the way that a crinkled quilt looks. And I will show you what that looks like in my blog post below the video. If you like this video, you can give it a thumbs up down below. You can also subscribe to my channel and click the bell alert if you want to be notified anytime that I post a video. Until next time, go get creative and make a sewing machine cover that you love. Bye!
Can I try and speak in this thing?
What are you gonna say?
Testing.
Okay.
Testing. Does it work?
Yeah.